Hello everyone and welcome to the course of CBRS, which is Citizens Broadband Radio Service by Telcoma Technologies. You can find the full course at telcomaglobal.com. CBRS, Citizens Broadband Radio Service, it is a 150 MHz wide broadcast band of 3.5 GHz, 3550 to 3700 MHz in the United States. Some of this spectrum will continue to be used by the United States government for radar system, but will be available for others when needed. So, radio spectrum is a limited resource, and unfortunately, technology can't create new spectrum. Technology can be used to improve the utilization of spectrum through the spectrum sharing techniques. So, CBRS is a spectrum allocation scheme that uses spectrum sharing. It, however, is not a new radio access technology. CBRS band is 150 MHz wide band in 3.5 GHz spectrum from 3550 to 3700 MHz. CBRS commercial service will use LTE as the radio access method. So, using CBRS non-traditional wireless carriers, it can offer services at lower cost than other cellular carriers. Numerous advantages are with using the LTE. It includes like roaming, enhanced security, low latency, high bandwidth, and large existing ecosystem. CBRS enables private LTE cellular networks to be deployed in a manner which are similar to the Wi-Fi. So, CBRS allows private wireless network to be built supporting campus and in-building applications. CBRS frequency band is a shared band, spectrum band, and there are three tiers of users which are defined by FCC in CFR 47.96. It has federal, state and local government along with the enterprises company. They are using CBRS, which will be able to build their own private LTE network with COTS technology. It has three-tier system, multiple users share the spectrum, and because of the user's different location and needs, overall efficiency and utilization of the spectrum will increase. What are the three tiers? They are ranked order of priority. Like first we are having incumbent access, then priority access license and general authorized access. This spectrum use is governed by an active shared spectrum policy. This policy controller is SAS, which is shared access system. This incumbents using IA, these are the federal radio location services, that means the radar, and wireless internet service provider who have priority over everyone else. The CBRS band is defined as LTE band 48, which is really LTE band 42-43, have been combined with 150 MHz of spectrum allocation. This band is TDD band, means that the CBRS devices transmit and receive on the same LTE channel as in Wi-Fi. The LTE channel size is 10 MHz, which affords a total of 15 possible channels in the band. It plays an important role in democratization of spectrum for IoT in case of industrial, medical, building, automation, hospitalities, industries, etc. So, CBRS spectrum used is governed by an active spectrum sharing policy, and it has a unique component to the CBRS network. This SAS, it is an external entity to an LTE network, and it interfaces with E-node B over the small cell. It controls when the small cell or E-node B can or can't transmit using the CBRS spectrum. Its purpose is to protect incumbent users that have the higher priority in the shared spectrum process for interference from the commercial user in this band. CBRS band is defined as LTE band 48. It has three tiers. At this moment, only IA and GAA users are defined. The PAL users and their spectrum allocation are expected to be finalized in first quarter of 2020. CBRS rules, it allows these users to request up to 4 of the 15 10 MHz channel that can possible to be used in this band. Right now, CBRS is available for commercial service offering using the GAA allocations. It has CBRS band has many objectives. First objective is it helps to like deployment of 4G mobile networks primarily with the PL license that has not been finalized yet, but it will be finalized. It is for IoT applications. CBRS using LTE technology opens up the entire ecosystem. CBRS is also planned to support 5G. In the near future, it offers a roadmap for future capabilities. Thank you.